The wardrobe department at my studios in Maastricht. It's here the outfits for my orchestra and soloists are all made by hand. Each dress can cost up to £4,000, and everyone in the orchestra has four identical outfits.
So when one set is on the way to Australia, and the other dresses and tuxedos are on the way to wherever. But it, you know, it's the only way to do it.
That's a lot of dresses, and each one is a work of art. Or not, in this case.
Go with them and try something else and show me.
Okay.
Yeah. The Liebenschweiger dresses were old, and we had them already a lot of times on stage, so they showed them to me, and I said, no, they are too old, they're too ugly, so go quickly and buy something else. I know when I say to the girls, go and buy a dress. Oh, they love it because I give them my credit card and rupee.
With this year's threat of concert looming, there's no time to make new dresses, so the girls hit the shops.
Andrew told me to buy dresses for soloists in Germany, so... Ladies!
Hi!
Dresses. Bye.
Do you like it?
Yes. Easy, but it's not.
It is more difficult to shop than to sing. And also that is the three of us, that they fit together. It's so complicated.
Carmen has been with me for 10 years, and during that time there is one dress which she's worn more than any other.
There was a dress, it made part of my life because probably I sang much more than 300 performances in it. That was the dress from Babbino Caro. It's made to look like Tuscany, Middle Ages. And I sang this number so many times that a copy had to be made because the original one was completely done.
In 2003 in Cortona, Italy, this beautiful aria by Puccini, the dress and Carmen's voice resulted in one of my favorite ever performances. And at last, I found some dresses to try on.
Ta-da!
Oh!
Is it nice?
Yes, very nice.
Which is good.
Oh, we have to make a picture for André.
Yeah.
So, I hope André liked it.
Next one.